I cannot speak very much with words. I tried to write a few books. I don't think they are so good. But I tried to explain myself in every ballet. Every time I do a ballet, sometimes I succeed, sometimes I fail, but I try to say something. In the case of Nutcracker, I try to tell the story of a young boy who has no more mother at the age of 7, and who is building a kind of hymn to the ideal mother that he has not more. And in his dance, in his way of dreaming, in his way of building a life and a story, he meets that woman who is maybe the mother, maybe the harpsichord. I didn't try to make a new story on Nutcracker. I just took the story of a young boy who happened to be me. I'm not sure really, you know, but I don't know really who I was at that period. A boy 7 years old, and the mother disappears, and the boy is dreaming, and the boy is alone, and in his dream, he built an enormous statue with his mother, his love, and because he cannot find this love, he became a dancer. So it's a really strange way to explain the story. I didn't try to keep any character of the ballet, the original story. One part of the music is really magic. So I need an element, a little magic, a little strange. And then for this one, I found Mephisto, that's the best character. Because I've been reading the Faust from Goethe very young. I took the book in my father's library, and I was fascinated by Mephisto. And you can see in the ballet a photo of me at the age of 9, dress and makeup like Mephisto. So this supposed to be Drosselmeier is Mephisto. And that's Mephisto. It's the same time Marius Petit Pas.
Dans ce Casse-Noisette, je fais un personnage, enfin je fais deux personnages, un Marius Petit Pas, méphistophélique, qui initie le jeune garçon Bim et qui l'aide, qui le violente, qui le fait passer par des mondes différents, jusqu'à la rencontre avec sa mère et jusqu'à une certaine maturité. Donc c'est une espèce d'initiation d'un enfant vers le métier de danseur et vers sa découverte intérieure.
Well, the second act usually is no story. It's just what you call divertissement. So I try to make the Mother's Day, and then for that day, the children build a circus, and then they are dancing different small dances for the mother, but even those dances, they are a reflection of the life, because the Spanish dance became, because when I was 13 or 14, I wanted to be torero. It's crazy, but I really wanted to be torero, and I studied to be torero. Then when I saw the Chinese dance, they go on bike. Why? Because during the war, we had no gas, we had no car, and all Marseille was like a Chinese city. Then so every part of the ballet still, it's a memory.
This is a very, very special production as far as the Nutcracker is concerned. I have to say that the idea of putting together the music of Tchaikovsky and some bits of French popular music through the accordion was Béjart's idea himself. So this is, I think, a brilliant, a very intelligent mixture of what Tchaikovsky means as far as the tradition of the waltz, for instance, which comes from Vienna to Russia through France in different and very subtly different forms. And these are put together in this ballet, which means that when Madame Yvette Horner comes into the stage playing a waltz, which is a waltz that everybody knows, it doesn't belong to Tchaikovsky, there is not a real break, there is a very natural link. I think this is brilliant.
Eh bien, l'accordéon est un instrument très noble qui peut jouer tout style de musique. Il est très populaire en France et ça a été prouvé qu'il y a également des accordéonistes qui sont des concertistes. Et donc, c'est un instrument qui se travaille comme tous les instruments dits classiques. Eh bien, j'ai une formation classique. J'ai donc... J'ai un prix au Conservatoire de Toulouse et je dois dire que j'étais destinée pour faire des concerts, du Beethoven, du Liszt, des choses comme ça, mais mes parents m'ont imposé l'instrument, l'accordéon. Donc comme j'étais une petite fille très disciplinée, et seulement on ne disait pas non à ses parents. Donc ce qui veut dire que j'ai continué à travailler mon piano, mais j'ai travaillé dans l'accordéon.
I was to start my career in London with International Ballet of Mona Ingelsby, directed by Nicolas Sergiev, assistant of Marius Petipas. And I was dancing in every classic ballet, not only in London, but I think I know better the English country than the France. And it's not one dig in the whole country where I didn't have cold tea, cold bed. And then I create my own way of dancing. It took me a long time, because it was a big work. But the base of the English ballet was still in me. And I must say that now, if you go on stage now, we have Mena Gilgood. You know the name Gilgood in England. I mean, she's teaching in the company. She's doing the class. So I think something from the Russian ballet through the English school came to us, and we are building our own way of dancing.
I joined Maurice Béjart's Ballet of the 20th Century way back in 1967, and I was with the company for 4 years, and it was one of the most wonderful times of my entire career. It was very creative. Béjart himself was creating for the women as much almost as for the men, because he's so well known for what he's done for male dancing. And I find myself in this extraordinary circle situation, as life sometimes does, of coming back to work with Maurice Béjart, but this time to try and give back a little bit. And I'm guest teaching here at the Châtelet in Paris during his season of the Nutcracker, and also coaching the Nutcracker Pas de Deux, which he has kept in the original version. Thank you. It's mixed. It's in a very interesting, I think, transition period, because there are now approximately half of the company come from the Rudra School, which Béjart founded in Lausanne. He also had a school, of course, in Brussels before that. And many of the students went on to perform in all sorts of companies as well as his own. But now there are quite a lot of youngsters from his school in Lausanne, as well as some fantastic, fantastic experienced professional dancers who have worked with him for some time and from whom the young ones can learn a great deal.
Hello, my name is Catherine Bradney. I'm American from New York. And in the Nutcracker, I'm dancing the fairy in the first part, and I'm dancing Paris in the second part. I've been working with Mr. Béjart for 14 years now.
My name is Juichi Kobayashi from Tokyo, Japan. I'm dancing role of cat in Nutcracker. I've been working with Mr. Béjart 10 years.
My name is Elizabeth Ross. I come from Spain. And in the Nutcracker of Maurice Béjart, I'm dancing the role of the mother. And it's 3 years that I'm working with the company.
Je me sens bien, sinon je n'aurais pas fait 11 ans. Donc je suis très bien à soi avec Maurice. On a des bonnes relations, donc on se comprend bien de ce qu'il veut. Je comprends quand il veut quelque chose, je comprends tout de suite. Et puis je continue comme ça, un peu dans le stress malheureusement, mais disons que autrement c'est assez bien. Comme relation, les costumes de Casse-Noisette donc que je les ai fait l'année passée. Et Maurice, quand il veut quelque chose, il vient, il me demande, il me dit voilà, je veux faire ça, ça et ça. Il me le met par écrit et puis comme ça après, bon, moi je réalise ce qui lui il demande parce qu'il sait très bien ce qu'il veut. Voilà.
J'ai commencé il y a une dizaine d'années avec Maurice. Mon premier ballet a été Tout in Vine. Puis j'en ai fait beaucoup d'autres. Et ça fait 10 ans que je travaille avec Maurice. Ça fait 10 ans d'aventure, 10 ans de galère, et d'aventure, de joie, de tristesse. C'est assez marrant. C'est beaucoup de travail. Parce que je ne fais pas que la lumière. Je m'occupe aussi de la direction technique. C'est très lourd. La compagnie tourne dans le monde entier, souvent sollicitée, partout dans l'Europe, au monde, États-Unis, Japon, Angleterre, entre autres. Mais c'est une aventure merveilleuse. Et je changerai pas pour un empire. L'éclairage du spectacle, si tu veux, ça a été. Maurice m'a fait part de. Je dirais de sa création par rapport à ce qu'il voyait pour Casse-Noisette. Et j'ai visionné des films qui sont présentés pendant le spectacle. Il m'a dit c'est plutôt une biographie. Je voudrais que la première partie se passe dans un studio. C'est pour ça que les miroirs ont été. Si on regarde bien le décor, il y a les miroirs qui ont été faits. C'est parce qu'on est dans un studio de danse. C'est sa volonté. Et l'éclairage a été fait à la base de ça. La deuxième partie, ça se passait plutôt comme une réjouissance, les souvenirs qu'il avait sur Marseille, c'est-à-dire les cirques, tout ce qu'il a vécu à Marseille. Il m'a dit, tu traites ça comme un cirque, c'est-à-dire c'est la féerie, c'est de l'amusement, et on est parti de ça pour traiter les lumières. C'est-à-dire que c'est un cirque. La deuxième partie, la première partie, c'est plutôt, il raconte la première histoire, sa vie, et après, la deuxième partie, on voit ce qu'il a vu lui, et ce qu'il a vécu.
I can't really remember when it started, because for me it was there always. When you hear my grandmother in the show, she say, as long as I remember, Maurice was only talking about theater and wanting to make theater, and I had no other pleasure than going or reading or watching actors, singers, dancers That's all.
The history of the theater, it has been built in 1862, when the Boulevard du Crime, where many theaters in Paris, was absolutely destroyed. And they built two theaters, the Théâtre de la Ville, which is just in front of this one, and which was called Sarah Bernard for many years, and this Théâtre du Châtelet. And then there was Russian season, Italian season, with Pavlova dancing here, Nijinsky, Diaghilev did a lot of works here also, the creation of L'après-midi d'un faune, Petrushka also. So that's really an historic theater. Other production now that we give, we have 20 performances, and it's sold out, well attended, welcomed by the audience and by the medias. So it's really a big, big success for the company and for Maurice Béjart, and of course for the Châtelet.
I think in Maurice Béjart's companies, at all times, whether it was large, whether it was small, when it started later on, based in Brussels, based in Lausanne, there's always been a tremendous sense of family, because various reasons, but most of all because everyone is here because of Maurice, because they admire his work, because they want to be part of his creative process. But also, I think, from everybody's side, because they love and admire him. And the other thing is, of course, his personality and the fact that he is 200% the company and 200% there for the dancers. And that just gives a sense and a feeling that you find in very, very few other ballet companies, if at all.
Maurice Béjart m'a téléphoné en me demandant si je voulais travailler avec lui. Et bien sûr, je lui dis que non seulement c'était un désir, mais c'était un grand honneur, bien sûr. Car ce monsieur est une... C'est une lumière. Et je suis vraiment ravie de travailler avec lui, avec toute l'équipe, qui est vraiment très... C'est une grande famille. Ce sont des danseurs qui ont beaucoup de talent. Et je suis vraiment ravie de cette collaboration. Voilà.
The mixture of the two worlds, Tchaïkovski's and the world of the popular music, doesn't create significant problems as far as performance is concerned, because the blending beforehand has been masterly handled. So I have to say that the normal problems that creates accompanying the ballet also become minimized, because Béjart is a very musical choreographer, is somebody who designs the movements of the dancers in a way that to accompany them becomes easy and becomes a real pleasure. So I must say that through the whole production, I didn't find other but pleasure working on that.
Marseille is a little bit like my mother, because I've been living in Marseille 17 or 18 years without going out of the town. But now I'm building a city who has nothing to do with the city who is there, because it's a dream, because you live a life and then you dream a life, and then you write your own life and you give it to the public, and when you see it, it's different. In the same way, when you make a novel about your own life, you're telling the truth and you're lying, because you are building the truth.
Très bien.
name is Juichi Kobayashi. Oh, shit.